take you to the Winnipeg Arena for an exciting classic wrestling match from the past.
Starting to go as a manager, and he's brought in several proteges from the Middle East and parts unknown that have been very devastating to the AWA. Adnan El Kassey, when he wants to be, can be a very outstanding wrestler.
Well, there you see Stan Lane working on that bad leg of Sheik Adnan El Kassey, and you've got to admit it's pretty good strategy, weaken one part of the body.
Well, everybody knows about what Mad Dog Vachon and Jim Brunzel did to El Kassey. Everybody knows that he's got a bad arm, he's got a bad leg.
And look at Stan Lane pulling the rope as far back as he can so that she can't get to him.
I think that's Keirn. You can't hardly tell him between both of these guys. I tell you, there's something else in professional wrestling. There's two. I mean, there isn't any two more guys that have shown more excitement, generate more electricity. The fans can really get with what these guys are doing. I tell you, they're modern up-tempo.
It's
just a lot of fun to be around.
The Sheik resorting to the tactics he uses, just wipes his fingernails across the back of Stan Lane.
Now, there's something that I think has got to be controversial. Using the cast to hit the guy. Several times the AWA has said he's got to wear a pad around there. He's wearing no pad now, but I can see it's not really a full cast. It's kind of a wrist cast. I think it's just something that El Kassey can use in case he's in trouble. It's just something he's trying to have an edge on his opponent.
The AWA checks that cast and the padding around it well before the match, but I have oftentimes thought the Sheik may remove a good deal of that padding prior to coming into the ring. It doesn't look to be very well padded from our vantage point.
Well, I don't want to say whether he does or whether he doesn't.
Stan Lane now getting to his feet. He's got that right fist cocked for the ball haymaker at him. Sheik goes for the trunks. Donnie goes again. Now he stops on the hand of Stan Lane. We've been joined over here at ringside by Steve Keirn. Watching the action intently again, the Sheik rakes those fingernails across the back of Stan Lane.
Right now, Stan's got to break the Sheik's momentum. The Sheik's got things going his way now. The tempo of the match is going just what he wants.
And again, the Sheik continues to hammer away at that cast. Kind of a mule kick there by Stan Lane.
I think it's more of a karate kick. Sheik decides he doesn't want to have any part of it.
And in goes Lane, right to work on the Sheik in the corner, hammering away, fists and boots. Now his head right into the turnbuckle above us. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. You give him 11 shots. Now what's he going to do? Look at this one. Gives him a number one sign. Up and down he goes with the Sheik with a shot to the throat.
He's doing a lot better.
Perhaps a little showboating there on Stan Lane, and out he goes. Now, wait a minute, look at this. Now, what are they doing now?
Wait a minute.
Stan Lane and Steve Keirn. Steve Keirn just whipped his shirt off. Now, Steve Keirn is taking his shirt off, and it's swept away. The referee didn't catch it for a minute. Now, look at Stan Lane coming around from the other side.
He's got it.
Look at this.
The roll.
There he goes. One, two, three. That was it. What a move.
There was no interference there. Keirn did not touch him. No interference. Lane, move around to the outside. What a move. One, two, three.
Back in, never did touch him. Distracted the Sheik. Stan Lane up from behind. The victory roll, the count of three, and the match goes to Stan Lane at a time of 6 minutes and 46 seconds. What a move on a fabulous one. They are something else.